guest panellist on Studio 10 this morning is the incredibly talented Shane Jacobson. Now, Shane, on your Twitter page, you say you're an actor, entertainer, presenter, supermodel and a florist. Are you really a florist?
No, I don't know.
Is this to do with deflowering? No, I
don't know. No, Petal. I just put florist. I don't know why. For moments like this, when interviews, when people go, yeah. Now, florist. And I don't know. It's just to see who actually looks at my Twitter. You're it.
Wow, he's a florist.
I mean, it's not too late. You could go to florist school. And maybe study hard in flower arrangement.
Have four children.
Oh. Yes, exactly.
I can get kids to pull them out of the ground, but they're not getting arranged.
Can I just say, I loved you in Time of Our Lives, which is on the ABC. Such an extraordinarily beautifully written, great acting, and it's so important that we continue to tell Australian stories, isn't it?
Yeah, and it had the two female producers of that show are incredible talents themselves, and one of them, Judy McCrossan, was one of the writers as well. Mm. And that's why they wrote such strong female characters within it. And that's what I miss on behalf of my mates who are in it. But I know for a fact that's why that it felt so now, so present. And very the lovely. Amount of feedback I used to get on the streets from families saying, gosh, we've just been through that issue, or, you know, we dealt with things like breast cancer and all that kind of stuff, and women stopping me on the street and saying, we're in the middle of dealing with that and your show helped us in some way. And I thought, that's not what I expected out of acting in a TV show, but, yeah, no, it was great to be part of.
I think, too, what I enjoy so much about you and your work is that you're almost the sort of perfect Aussie bloke.
Mm-hmm. I'll take that.
Yeah, but in terms of your sort of your humour, this, you're sort of down to earth.
Earthy,
and that's,
yeah, dry.
And it just seems to come through in your roles. Like, I adored you in Kenny.
Me too.
That was
my
so
favourite film.
Funny.
Yeah.
We've had a chat about this.
Yeah.
My brother and my, we had many, many great moments and memories during and post Kenny. But we were in London for the premiere, and yours truly was standing on the red carpet with Barry Humphries.
Yeah.
And Barry came, which I was in character, and my brother had said to me, listen, we should learn from the master. Let's not recreate anything here. Once you put the hat on and we dress as Kenny, you stay in character. Mm. And we took that from the master, from Barry. So I turn up on the red carpet in London and you're there with Barry and there's my brother and you and Barry standing there.
Wow.
So I had to meet Barry Humphries as Kenny and stay in character. And thank goodness my brother afterwards got to say, we did that because of you, Barry. You know. But I wanted to go, oh, my God, it's Barry Humphries.
It's Barry's
favourite
film.
But instead I had to say, oh, it's great to meet you, Barry.
Did you hear that? It's really Barry's favourite film.
Okay, well, now
he'd
I'm
already
just
seen
blush.
It, and he took me because he said it was a comedic delight. And
it's great, it is. Isn't it? Yeah. Yeah. So the chicks all love the moving TV show about breast cancer, and the blokes just love the film about the toilets.
I like the toilets too.
Toilet humour, the ultimate. Yeah,
of course we love the toilets. Try and live without one.
Mate, that Dunny film, that was just bang on.
Shane, super quickly, working on Oddball, tell us about that movie.
Yes, it's a film coming out this year. So it's based on a true story. In Warrnambool, down in Victoria, there was an island, is an island. Island, only just 100 metres off the shore in Warrnambool. There was 1,000 penguins on it, a colony, and the foxes figured out they could cross at low tide, and they decimated the population from 1,000 down to about 10. Mm. And a character, which I play in the film, a real man in Warrnambool called Swampy Marsh, is a chicken farmer. Yeah, that's me playing Swampy. So there's a Maremma dog, and Swampy Marsh down in Warrnambool has Maremma dogs that protect his chickens. And he said to the council, oh, they're gorgeous, they're amazing. And he just said, look, my Maremma dogs look after, they look after chickens and guard them. And he said, you know, penguins are just chickens in tuxedos. So let's put the dogs on the island. And he was right. And he revolutionised the conservation practice of penguins. So it's a true story, and he saved the penguins with his dogs. So it's based on that. It's a beautiful film.
When does it come out?
End of this year, and it's one for the whole family. It's gorgeous because it's real.
Mm. Animal magnetism, I think.
Yes.
To dump that. Yeah.
Is this me now or the dog?
Oh, yes, darling.
I'll take that as well.
Now, you can put all this on your Twitter account now.